will discuss about ameloblastoma. This is a slow growing benign tumor, but there is locally aggressive nature, that is locally invasiveness into the surrounding bone with high recurrence rate if untreated well, right? So there is high recurrence rate also. Then Robinson defined ameloblastoma as a usually unicentric. Unicentric means there is only single center of tumor origin, right? Single center from where tumor originates, that is unicentric. And non-functional, that is there is no specific function, okay? It is non-functional and intermittent in growth, intermittent slow growth, and anatomically benign and clinically persistent. Persistence is nothing but growing. Clinically it is a complete growth without any spontaneous cessation. That means tumor doesn't cessate or doesn't stop its growth. It is slow growing continuous process. That is called as clinically persistent. Then mandible is commonly involved than the maxilla, and posterior part of the mandible, that is mandibular posterior body and mandibular ramus angle region, is the commonly involved region when compared to the anterior region. And there is equal predilection in male and female. And third and fourth decade is of third and fourth decade patients are commonly seen, right? Then coming to the pathogenesis, there is single point. Ameloblastoma originates from the odontogenic epithelium, right? And after that, from that odontogenic epithelium, it may develop from the developing enamel organ or cell rest, that is remnants of enamel organ. It may develop from a developing enamel organ. That means tooth is not still formed completely. Or it may develop after the complete development of tooth from the cell rest of enamel organ. That is some remnants. They may be remnants of dental lamina or remnants of Hertwig's epithelial root sheath, right? Otherwise called as epithelial rest of malacis. These terms we have to write. Right, developing enamel organ, otherwise odontogenic epithelium, or remnants of dental lamina, or remnants of Hertwig epithelial sheath, that is cell rest of malacis, or it may develop in some cases of cysts epithelium. It may develop from epithelium of some cyst like dentigerous cyst, like that. This is about from where it originates. That is called as pathogenesis. These are very much gunshot points, right? Then coming to the types, ameloblastoma basically divided into the central and peripheral varieties, two varieties. Central is nothing but intraosseous, that means that develops within the bone. Peripheral is nothing but the extraosseous, that means it develops surrounding the gum tissue or anything, that is soft tissues. Mostly it is the gum, right? So there are two varieties. In central, again we have multicystic variety or unicystic variety. You can see in these diagrams, multicystic is nothing but there is appearance of multicyst and there is lacules. In this diagram, you can see that there is the ameloblastoma of mandibular angle region and body region also. These two small spaces are nothing but the lacules, that is giving a multicystic appearance. This is also called as solid ameloblastoma or conventional ameloblastoma. That means it is most commonly occurring one. Conventional, right? So this is multicystic. And another variant is unicystic. That means there is no lacules and tumor appears as a single cyst. You can see here. Tumors appears as a single cystic appearance, right? In this again, we have luminal, intraluminal and mural. In unicystic ameloblastoma, we have three varieties, right? You can see here. That means if I take this part, if I take this cystic lining, you can see here, right? I have taken this cystic lining only in this case. This red line is nothing but the epithelium and this center hollow part is nothing but the lumen. Lumen means blood vessels also has the lumen. Lumen is nothing but the central hollow part, right? and we have the connective tissue in the epithelial wall. So luminal means, luminal is nothing but the epithelium lining the lumen. That means if you have a center hollow part, that epithelium lining this hollow part is nothing but the luminal part. So if the tumor develops from this luminal part, then it is called as the luminal amyloblastoma. In this case, you can see this is the epithelium lining the lumen. You can see there are the number of cells developed here. There are increased cell layers. This is nothing but the amyloblastoma development. You can see there is only two cell layers remaining part, and in this case there is increased thickness of the epithelial lining. That is why it is called as luminal. Then intraluminal is nothing but tumor growth into the lumen, into the hollow part, right? You can see this blue color is nothing but the intraluminal. That means tumor growth is into the lumen, into the hollow part. Mural is nothing but the tumor growth in the connective tissue. You can see in this diagram, this black colored one is the connective tissue. So these black colored solid islands are tumor growth, epithelial growth into the connective tissue is called as mural. So there are three varieties of unicystic amyloblastoma. And peripheral amyloblastoma is nothing but the most commonly occurs in gums, that is soft tissues. This is all about types of amyloblastoma. There is histological types also, six variants we'll discuss later. Then coming to the clinical features, most common clinical feature is nothing but the painless, slow growing swelling. Painless, slow growing swelling. If it is secondarily infected, then it may become painful, but most commonly it is painless, right? When it is secondarily infected, you can see the draining sinuses or ulceration of the overlying mucosa, right? And if the amyloblastoma involves maxilla, then there may be nasal obstruction or maxillary sinus involvement. There is not much clinical features in amyloblastoma. The most important thing is nothing but the painless, slow growing swelling, right? Then we will discuss about the radiological features. Radiological feature, it can be multilocular or unicystic, right? That is multicystic appearance or unicystic appearance. So these are the gunshot points in radiological features. The multilocules may produce soap bubble appearance or honeycomb appearance. That means if the locules are larger, then it will result in soap bubble appearance, somewhat large cystic cavities, right? You can see in this diagram. If the locules are small, then it will result in honeycomb appearance or honeycomb pattern. You can see in this diagram. Locules are small when compared to the soap bubble appearance, right? These two appearances are because of multicystic nature. Then root resorption. And radiologically what you can see is root resorption. Okay, there are two main differentiating factors between the tumor and cyst. In tumor, there is root resorption rather than root displacement. You can see in this diagram, this is the molar root resorbed. You can see small roots here. That is, root resorption will lead to the mobile teeth. In tumors, we have root resorption. In case of cyst, there is no root resorption. That is most commonly you will not see the root resorption, but due to the pressure, the roots are displaced. Roots are displaced. This is one important point. And second important point is, in case of tumors, the buccolingual expansion, swelling expansion occurs on both sides. That is, buccal cortical plate as well as the lingual cortical plate, both cortical plates are expanded. But in case of cyst, mostly it is the buccal cortical plate which get expanded. Lingual cortical plate, we will not see the expansion in cases of cyst. These are the two main important features what you can differentiate between the tumor and cyst, right? Accordingly, we have root resorption and both buccal and lingual cortical plate expansion. If this expansion is too much, then it will result in the perforation also. You can see in this diagram, this is the mandibular occlusal view, right? And this is the ameloblastoma. You can see both buccal cortical plate and lingual cortical plate expansion with multicystic nature, right? If this expansion is too much, which leaves the thin cortical plate, then it will result in egg shell crackling because of the very thin cortical bone, and it will lead to the cortical perforation also, right? These are the main important points in radiological features. And you can see the unicystic ameloblastoma also. We have already discussed. Unicystic is nothing but only one cystic nature. And the border is scalloped. You can't see a smooth border as in the cases of cyst. In the cyst, there is smooth border, right? But in case of ameloblastoma, this border is scalloped like this. Border is scalloped. This is also one of the main important points. These are the radiological features. Radiologically, ameloblastoma is divided into multicystic and unicystic ameloblastoma. That's all. Then coming to the histological types, there are 6 histological varieties of ameloblastoma. Most common is the follicular ameloblastoma. Second most is plexiform ameloblastoma. And we also see granular cell ameloblastoma, acanthomatous ameloblastoma, and desmoplastic ameloblastoma, and basal cell ameloblastoma. Right, there are 6 types. In follicular ameloblastoma, we'll see the islands of epithelium. Right, this is one island of epithelium, and this is another island of epithelium, and this is the another island of epithelium. Right, there are these points are very much important. In follicular ameloblastoma, we have the islands of epithelium. In plexiform ameloblastoma, we have sheets. Sheets are cards of ameloblastoma. Right? If you take an island, there are 2 components. Centrally, we'll see spindle shaped cells resembling a stellate reticulum pattern. These red colored ones are nothing but the spindle shaped cells resembling stellate reticulum. And surrounding that, we have one single layered tall columnar cells. Right? These are tall columnar cells. There is only one single layer. And the nucleus of these cells is arranged or polarized away from the basement membrane. Right? This is a structure what you can see in the island of epithelium. We have similar islands that is constitute follicular ameloblastoma. Then coming to the plexiform ameloblastoma, as I said, there is sheets or cards of ameloblastoma. You can see here, this is one sheet of epithelium and this is another sheet of epithelium, this is another sheet of epithelium. The underlying material is same, right? But when compared to the follicular ameloblastoma, this stellate reticulum or spindle shaped cells are less in case of plexiform ameloblastoma. Right? And again, we have the tall columnar cells polarized, their nucleus polarized away from the basement membrane. Same thing. But what we can see here islands, we can see here plexiform sheets or cards. Right? There is no need to go in detail about this. Right? This is the main 2 varieties of histopathological ameloblastoma. Right, and this is the case of unicystic ameloblastoma. We have discussed it already. Then coming to the diagnosis, based on the history, clinical features and radiological features and histopathological examination, you have to diagnose the ameloblastoma. Histopathological examination is the definitive way to diagnose or confirm the diagnosis of ameloblastoma is to do the histopathological examination. Right, then coming to the differential diagnosis, the most common location of the ameloblastoma is posterior part of the mandible. So what are other regions which are most commonly occur in the posterior part of the mandible includes odontogenic keratocyst, OKC, right, or dentigerous cyst, or odontogenic myxoma, calcifying epithelial odontogenic tumor, CEOT, then fibroosseous lesions. These are the differential diagnoses. That means we have to differentiate ameloblastoma from these varieties, these pathologies. histopathologist, right? The definitive way is to do the histopathological examination to confirm any diagnosis, especially these fibroosseous lesions are confused with the desmoplastic variety of ameloblastoma. Because normal conventional ameloblastomas involve posterior mandible region, but in desmoplastic ameloblastoma, there is tendency to involve the anterior mandible or in between the premolars where fibroosseous lesions are common. Right, and you have to differentiate ameloblastoma from all these pathologies. Right, this is all about differential diagnosis. Now we'll discuss about the management in next video. If you like this video, hit the like button, share the video, subscribe the channel.